recently was. So I did know that before, yes, but not the detail, obviously, because you'd be very careful about things like that. But yeah, I did know quite a lot. I established a great friendship with that. A re-established, if you like. I think he felt it was useful for the valve. You don't think words and all that. And I would listen to him and I would never upbraid him or talk about, should I? But it was kind of twist on the act and everything. We were equal to him. We were.
You were also channels in the background.
Yes, yes, that's right.
And he was busy and struggling and up to an extent trying on patterns.
Well, he was, yes, yes.
And then came the very first.
Thank you for that. Towards his own family, and his family was quite a lot of money, and that day, and he said, but he was, and I've heard since that cancer patients, even though they know they are fainter, they get a sense of optimism, and he said, all the things we discovered, I think, during the night, have I been on, I have my radio, and they're all right, you know, he still was imbued himself with hope, all of it turned out to be. But at the period in all that time, he really looked good to me. He came to and he'd say, oh, I'm sure to be okay. But you see, he wasn't, he was. And I think, I actually think, and I don't want to sound a martyr, but I actually think what a loss he was to Ireland. To Ireland as a country, as a leader, what he was, because he was a very special person. Very special.
His own son, Tom, this week, said that he wouldn't have wanted Brian to give up politics after the diagnosis.
No, he said
and to give it at home. Yeah.
He said he should.
Do you think it was better for Brian to be busy?
I suppose, though, in the book I'd say maybe he took too much out of himself, but he never appeared so taxed, so like unduly taxed, that he couldn't cope. You know, he didn't ever exhibit that in his manner or in his, and I would meet him almost daily, there were votes in the law all the time. He brought through 24 pieces of legislation in that 2 years.
But he did struggle with it since the two challenges, one of the other of the Adam job he had.
What Ireland was facing. And he found it very difficult to, no, not to explain, he was a great communicator, and he always went on radio and television and explained what was happening. And we're trying to bring people with him on the steps of the winning. But at the same time, he found it very difficult. I know, you know, he was off very patient with the background of the people. And, but he found it very difficult to explain how horrendous this was going to be. and we all know how horrendous it has been and will be continues to be for people who are caught up with it.
I've got one more question. I don't think any questions.
What time is it now?
We're another 5 minutes.
What time is it finishing?
About 10 past 2. It's about 5 past 2.
It's now 4:15, 20 past.
To ask a question.
Hello.
Up there at the back, I'll try. We get the microphone. We try the help desk if we can.
Yeah, because I like to see the person. It's very rude for there to be able to see me and not to see them.
Hello, Mary. It's nice to have you here.
Hello.
I'm Margaret Havlin and I'm involved with the CDC in Kilkenny, being involved.
All right.
And I've been involved in